So, hello to the very few people that watch my YouTube, and welcome back to Let's Play This War of Mine, The Little Ones. We're currently at day 32, and you can go to bed, mate. And yeah, I'm thinking there will be no more war in a couple of days, maybe tomorrow even. So we stayed in last night, and yeah, that's it. Basically nothing left to do, really, than to wait for the war to be over. We have enough food to last us a couple of days, and we really don't need anything else right now. So yeah, things are going quite smoothly. Besides the death of Roman, who joined our little group not too long ago, and we sent him out to the church, and I screwed up and he got shot and he was dead. So yeah, but all of Bob really didn't care. She didn't really care that much. She just wondered where he went, and he also really didn't care that much. There's some kids at the door. As soon as she's done with the water, she can go see what they want. Yeah, I'm coming. Hold your horses. Somebody wake up. No. Hello. Oh sure, why not? Just hang on for a second. I'm sure Crystal will wake up any minute now. So yeah, nothing much to do. Maybe check another log. Oh, nothing left to burn. Well, really doesn't matter. It's warm enough. Yeah. Christo's coming. Don't you worry. Do I have anything to give them? If they want food, no. If they want meds, also no. Yeah. Don't have that right now, but you can come back later if you want. And nobody also actually cared. So yeah, that's enough for today. The kids came by, didn't have any food. Might as well end the day now and see what happens tomorrow. Maybe the war's over, maybe not. No need for me to go out again. How much bullets do I have left before I say that? 7 more bullets should be enough to come through the survive the night if they try to break in. So let's just end the day. Yes, please. And it's peace time. So let's see what the story tells us. A new home. We found a new home. We were to stay here until the war is over. Day 2. We ignored the visitors. Someone was at the door. They might have needed our help, but we didn't open. Okay. Pavel was seeking shelter. Pavel was looking for shelter, and we let him stay with us. That was day 5. Also day 5. Unexpected gift. Our neighbor brought us a supply of wood to help us last through difficult times. Day 11. Neighbors in need. Our friendly neighbors came to ask us for help in reinforcing the shelter. We were happy to help them. Day 12. Father and child. Pavel helped a man who was wounded by a sniper while coming home to a sick child. Day 22. A sniper's victim. Our neighbor's brothers got wounded by a sniper's bullet. Christo helped carry him to safety. Day 23. Winter. Winter was very cold, but at least I could build a snowman. Too bad my friends weren't there to see it. Day 28. Saving life. Our neighbor's children asked us for medication. We shared a little what we had with them. Day 29, 8 requests, we gave away some goods to the help the hospital. Ah, Roman, on day 30 Roman was killed while looking for supplies. I didn't even mention him joining us. And on day 32 there was a ceasefire. The long awaited ceasefire finally came into force, eventually putting an end to the fighting in Pagaran. Those who survived war will never forget it. After the ceasefire came into effect, the whole family reunited. Despite the harsh reality of the war, Iskra managed to remain unscarred. She resumed school, and when she went to college, she started writing stories for children as a pastime. But and became quite popular. Her new best friend, a fat cat that she named Mr. Whiskers, helped her get rid of her fear of rats. Pavel survived the war. After months of searching, despite numerous difficulties, he managed to find his wife and son, who had sought refuge in France. He went there to live with them. They never came back to Pagaran. When the war ended, Christo managed to reunite with his wife. Luckily, she was unhurt. They resumed work and did their best to alleviate the effects war had on Iskra, as well as ensure she had a normal childhood. Perhaps with a lot of love and care, they would succeed. As so many other tough-as-nails guys, Roman didn't make it. His motivation will remain unknown to his buddies, and some of them still think he betrayed them. Poor Roman. So that was This War of Mine, The Little One, the story of Iskra, Pavel, Christo and also Roman. I thank you all for watching, and I hope you enjoyed the series. So thank you all for watching, goodbye, and maybe I will make another let's play of this game with some other survivors. Thank you, bye bye.